Hello everyone, I'm Chris Colley from The Front Row, and today we've been granted access to an exclusive showroom for Anitanja and her jewelry, originating from St. Lucia, but I want her to give you the greatest description of it because I'm horrible with words and she is flawless with hers. So without further ado, thank you Anitanja for allowing us this access. And please, please tell us a little bit about your collection and its origin and what inspired you to start this collection.
Thank you, Chris. I'd love to. So the whole Anitanja collection is inspired by St. Lucia and the beauty of the island. We have a gorgeous volcanic landscape, so mountainous interior. We have lovely beaches, beautiful rainforests. And I grew up in the southwest of the island, which is very rural, very rugged, and very lush still, very untouched. And I didn't have any television growing up, and it was all it was all about being out in nature.
Poor child.
And yes, but I enjoyed it. And from early on, I did have a desire to express myself creatively, but we had no hobby shops, no art supply shops anywhere. And
so that could be hard.
Really, collecting what was on these beaches and in the rainforest, and getting drift material and stringing them together, or making little sculptures. That was my my sort of creative outlet.
So you were already starting to frame your niche while you were young. That's good.
So I started out doing assembled pieces with just found objects.
Oh, okay.
And then later on, I really wanted to have something that was a bit more permanent and lasting. And I looked for a very long time on the island to see if I could learn from silversmiths there, but it's not really part of the culture there. We have a few Guyanese goldsmiths, but they use a different method. It's not generally casting method or lost wax casting. They do more of a stamped gold technique, and I was really interested in learning wax carving, casting.
Now, did you learn that over there?
So then I had to leave the island, which I was very sad about.
I can imagine. Leaving St. Lucia, always sad.
Eventually had to get used to living in the city. I moved to London for a few years and learned some techniques over there from a lovely woman who had a gallery. And I would take night classes with her, and she would let me use her studio space.
For your own creativity?
For my own creativity.
It's a great woman.
I just experimented, and it was more trial and error. So I didn't really have much formal training. I spent many days and nights going over techniques and
trial and error kind
and
of
doing it
yeah.
again.
And here we are today.
Here we are.
Take us through some of the collections, because I know we have the Sea Fan collection.
Yes, so the sea fan is a collection inspired by the actual sea fan corals. I don't know if you've ever been scuba diving, snorkeling. They're these beautiful filigree corals. Actually, I've got one right here.
Wow.
It's many different variations. It's very delicate. And I live about 5 minutes from the beach. Every morning I go.
The hardships you go through.
And I collect whatever the ocean has brought up at night. And these beautiful objects are there every day. And for years I've wanted to do something with it, but just because they're so delicate, it makes it a very difficult object to cast. I took almost 2 years in the making to figure out a technique to get them thick enough to cast.
Now let me ask you this, just for our viewers, when you say cast, do you mean you actually use the coral pieces?
Yes, exactly.
Wow.
Exactly. So for the first prototype I ever did, I had to thicken it so that we could make a mold, a silicone mold, and that gets injected with wax.
That's incredible.
Wax gets put into a plaster cast.
Okay.
Melted out, and then that hollow cavity gets injected, high pressure machines with molten metal, and that's part of the process.
That just gave me a whole nother appreciation for your jewelry.
It's a very time consuming process.
Yes, but the result is beautiful.
Yeah.
The result is gorgeous.
And it's something that you know, a lot of creative people come across, that sometimes you have an idea and it's in your head and you can see it in front of you, but then it's just not, you know, technically, just so many more steps involved that you are, you know, not quite prepared for.
Well, I'm glad you weren't discouraged, because a lot of people would be. I mean, that's a lot to, just to first find these and then to cast it and make it into something that's beautiful is commend. I should commend you just for that alone.
Oh, well, I can't help but see the beauty. I mean, you would as well if you spent any time on stage.
Oh, no, I see it here. I can't go to St. Lucia right now, but you brought it to us, which is great. So also, let's talk about your HSN. Should I say collaboration or appearance?
Yes, it is a collaboration.
It's a collaboration.
Absolutely. We hope
so give them more details about that.
We have a sub-brand that mm-hmm. we've created for HSN. It will be running under Aja for Anitanja.
Okay.
Aja by Anitanja, sorry.
Gotcha.
So it's going to be a more affordable line, mm-hmm. Very accessible.
Mm-hmm. Now let me ask you a question. I'm not to cut you off.
Not any less beautiful.
This is what I've always wanted to know. And when you're pairing with HSN, how did that come about? Was it your staff that brought that about? Did they reach out to you and saw your jewelry and said we want to pair up, or did you submit jewelry? How did that whole process come about?
Well, I was very lucky in that my business partner, who's a guru when it comes to connecting people, and he had a connection to Mindy Grossman.
Okay.
And it was actually Mindy herself who spotted the bracelet and said that she had to have it.
Oh, there you go. No better way to sell it than actually someone wanting it. So that's great.
Yes,
that's so great. Which bracelet did she actually go?
It was a variation of this one.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
No.
So it's like the organic sea fan shape, but what we've done here is we've embedded it with a pave CZs.
Oh,
and the CZs to me are almost like, you know, when you see
it's
the wet sea fan on the beach
mm-hmm.
and it has the water droplets in it and the sunlight hits it,
mm-hmm.
you get these millions of little stars and
right. little rainbows and
yes.
absolutely.
So,
oh my goodness.
So I love that combination of the sea fan and the CZs. I think it works really well.
That's amazing. So that's the sea fan collection.
Yes.
Wait, before we go on, let's just give a little more detail about the sea fan collection. I don't want to skip over it because
sure.
it's so beautiful and took so much to make.
Well, we have this one, which is a sort of a neck cup, very easy to wear. You just slip it on and off.
Oh, that's gorgeous.
It's very regal.
That's
very
gorgeous. Absolutely. That is this.
Yes. That
okay.
is that.
That's gorgeous.
We have this one with black pearls. Then we've got a stackable puzzle ring, which you can wear all together.
Nice.
You can fit it and you play around with it, or you mm-hmm. can divide
put
it
that right.
And it makes fabulous gifts. You know, I can see it for sisters. If you have three sisters, you each get one, or three best friends, and that
I
sort
actually
of thing.
Have two sisters, so you just gave me a Christmas
you
gift
know,
idea.
Where
there you go.
Things that sort of bind them together and little reminder of friendship
now,
ring of sorts.
Now, do they come together in one package, or
yes,
do you buy?
Yes, these are sold together.
Oh, that's mm-hmm. my gosh, that's good.
But yeah, I like the idea of having mixed and matched.
Yeah, no, that's really good.
Then, what else do we have here? We have this is an offshoot off of the original Sea Fan collection, and it's called. Sorry, I apologize. I'm a bit congested.
Oh no, don't worry about it. So was I. The weather here in New York is crazy.
Yes, it's nothing like island weather.
So she rubs it in again
about St. Lucia.
Looking
forward to the sunshine. this is the medallion collection.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Which
I'm so scared to touch delicate items.
Oh no, it's actually this is quite well made and it's you don't.
Oh this to oh this is oh okay. This is beautiful.
So it is it's a little bit more structured than the freeform original sea fan shape that we had. And the whole medallion shape, it kind of reminds me of this sort of sunken treasure, like the old Caribbean coins that you would pick up.
I recently traveled to Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
And they were telling us about the coins. And so that's amazing that you told me that. So now I know they weren't lying. Because I thought that was just a story they were telling us just to make the trip interesting.
No.
Oh, that's amazing.
So it's
though.
A little bit more structured than the original version.
That is gorgeous.
We're playing around.
Now, all of this will be available on HSN?
Absolutely. Wow. The majority of this will be.
And will it be only on HSN or can it be found also in stores? Or?
We are open to absolutely everything at this point.
Okay.
We have very exciting news in that we just recently joined forces with a distributor in the Caribbean. So they will be available in some upscale duty-free shopping areas.
Nice.
St. Thomas, St. John.
St. Bart?
Turks and Caicos. Hopefully St. Bart's.
I may have someone for you out there.
Oh,
so that's
wonderful.
Good. So I have a boutique.
Yes, and certainly everything is available on the website.
Okay.
So anitanja.com. People can order straight off of the page.
Now let's spell it for those people that may be slow out there.
It's Anitanja.
.com. You have no excuse not to go and find it. So
and
now
we have lots more coming, by the way.
A lot
so what you see on
of
the website,
C-Fan collection?
Of everything.
Of just everything.
You know,
okay.
We have four collections that we're working on at this
okay.
point.
What's the next collection?
The next
because
song.
Now you sold me. I'm interested.
To give out secrets like this.
No, I'm talking about the Coco collection.
Oh right. But I will tell. I trust you with these secrets.
Oh,
so I will let you know what the next collection is.
It's only us and 10 million, 20 million viewers, no problem.
So the next one is the Coco collection.
Okay.
And besides from being absolutely obsessed with chocolate and...
I am right there with you.
I mean, who isn't?
Right there with you.
Making my own chocolates as well is something I've gotten into of late, doing raw chocolates.
This woman does everything.
I love cocoa butter for making my own body products.
I'm right there with you.
Yeah.
Cocoa butter and chocolate, you sold me already.
Everything from chapped lips to, you know, soothing the hands and...
you had me and chocolate. So this is the cocoa collection
yes,
here?
This is the cocoa collection. I grew up, you know, surrounded by cocoa farms. And I've always been intrigued by those lovely grooves. You know, it has just such a beautiful shape with the colors and...
Such as here,
yes. So what I've done here is that we've got two variations of it. The one
is
just a miniature pod itself.
This here?
Yes, which
this
has been
gorgeous.
Sliced on beneath to let the cocoa beans spill out. The cocoa
you
beans are in fact tiny fresh water pearls.
That is detail.
So
that is detail. Oh, that is gorgeous. That is beautiful.
Thank you.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, so it has a very playful element.
It does.
These pearls, they have movement. And
but it still adds to the beauty of it. It doesn't take away from the actual collection of the jewelry. So that's great.
Thank you.
This is really beautiful.
Oh, I'm glad you like it.
Oh no, I really do.
You'd be happy to know, actually. We have, this is the only line that we carry something in for men as well. We do
Coco
cufflinks, which is a man dressed with such style, gorgeous suits.
Thank you.
I think that would go very well.
The cufflinks
actually
will
right
go.
Here.
Oh, yes. Yes. Everyone out there, Christmas gifts for
cocoa
men.
Cufflinks.
The cufflinks would be great. Oh, these are beautiful. And now, are you allowed to give out the price points?
Well, we would like
you have to
have
to
people
wait
just go to the website.
There you go.
Lately, I just have so many numbers in my head, it's hard to...
I've been well trained, you see. You don't ask someone a question like that. No,
I'm wearing the little drop earrings
from
the cocoa, which are really sweet. These make a lovely gift as well.
They are. They're gorgeous. They really are. To match with the bracelet as well?
Yes. So, yeah.
That would be perfect.
We've got tassel bracelets, we've cuffs. This is a very popular ring here as well. It's a very simple band. It's just these little cocoa lined up together.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. But it's still, everything still has a delicate feel, but you can tell with the holding them and actually being in front of them that they're really well made.
Yeah.
Which is very, very
substantial. And the originals are all handmade, you know, which, you know, we don't currently use any CAD. We may in the future do that. But at this point in time, every single first piece has been hand carved in wax.
Oh, wow.
They are really miniature sculptures.
I mean, what don't you do over here? So this is the second collection. This is C-Fan.
Well, there's another variation of the cocoa. I just wanted to mention
okay, sure.
That. So apart from the actual
is
miniature
it over here?
Pod. Yes.
Mm-hmm. This one?
I'm wearing a piece here as well, and you can see it there.
Oh.
It's the cross section.
Okay.
That's so gorgeous. When you cut open the pod, you have the alignment of the five seeds inside.
Gotcha. And there it is.
Yeah.
Oh, so you really brought the island to your collection.
Absolutely. I have to.
But you know what I've seen just through taking me through the jewelry, I've seen your attention to detail because, like I was telling you in the showroom, the earrings are what caught me because of so much detail on both sides, especially with dangling earrings. A lot of women complain that one side doesn't look too good and the other one is just right because they usually focus on the outside. She focuses on both sides. So any way that you're looked at as far as your ears, you're well taken care of. And that's what really attracted to me and showed me that she had an attention to detail. This just further backed up my confirmation right here. Like, the attention to detail with actually slicing the coconut open and showing the cocoa leaf. The cocoa.
So we might do coconut soon.
But I need to go to St. Lucia, so I'm hint, hint. And but that attention to detail is what really attracted me to her as a designer, to her collection. And I definitely want all of you to really understand her story about what she said in the beginning, because this was a long process in the making. And you can tell by when she had to first collect seashells, and there were nothing else to collect but just the nature and the natural elements that she had around her. And now look what it is today. So I just want to thank Anitanja for giving us this time, letting us into her beautiful showroom. And once again, this is Chris Colley, and we're here at From the Front Row. We'll see you next time.
Thank you.
It's been a pleasure over the last, I guess, intense year. It feels like 10 years. But the last year, we've built something amazing with this team, and it's been incredible to see us grow and begin to work together and just create something that's bigger than each of us individually. So it's been a real pleasure for me, and just to see the dedication and energy that this team has put behind this project. It's been phenomenal.
Every single person in this room can think of a time in their lives where they had a forked road, where they had to decide. And so I would just encourage that, at least based on my experience, going with what you're passionate about, and especially in these times, going with something that you can really wake up every morning and feel good about is, you know what, that's the road to take right now. Because just as 2012 was the beginning of the emergence of domestic manufacturing again, you don't have to take it from me. Maid Collection came out that year, Maker's Row came out that year, Flint and Tinder came out that year. That was when things really started. And I'm proud to be among them, and I'm proud to call those people my friends. You know, then 2013 came along, and it really was about banding together. It was about community. It was about us all actually finding each other. I mean, how much work was that to actually find this community of makers, of creatives, of sustainability experts, you know, connecting in the fashion tech for the first time with the traditional fashion, you know? I mean, maybe not for the first time, but for the first time for a lot of us. Yeah. And so, you know, that was really what 2013 was about, was building that community. And that infrastructure building is the most important part of this movement, and will continue to make this movement successful as long as we emphasize that and keep our eye that on each individual designer, manufacturer, creative, maker. Every single person that's a part of this process is important, matters, and that's the connectivity. That's the community. That's our Internet of Things. It's not an Internet of Things. It's an Internet of People.